give you, they become extraordinary. People like Victor Lopez, or Robert Smith, or Jack Bullock, or James Walker, playwright, and Jay Dawson. And my favorite one is James Swearingen, because he likes old brass. These are the arrangers of the songs we're about to play. Christmas songs are in the public domain, but these people have been given a gift by God to give something that's familiar, a little twist, so that once again we can hear it as something extraordinary. With that in mind, let's pray. Gracious God, we give you thanks for all that is in this world. And we give thanks that you are a wonderful arranger. Day by day, you take what is common, even what we have taken for granted, and with a little twist, you once again make it extraordinary. And you do this all the time. Thank you for this Christmas season. And even here, may we see it with a different perspective because of your arranging, for the remarkableness that it truly is. Thank you for the gift of music. In your name we pray.
Sure to be uplifted by this combination of winter wonderland and sleigh riding. classical musicians, including Shalem and Chassi on violin, Kaya on viola, Rakem on cello, and Sitska on double bass and piano. The Lorich brothers have been producing and performing their own concert programs over 4 years. Most of their music programs contain Baroque, classical, and romantic music. Each program is closed with a hymn. Currently, they perform at many other events, including musical productions and orchestras, special music in churches, community events and weddings, background music for luncheons, honor banquets, fundraisers, and more. If you are interested in having them for your special occasion, just let us know and we'll get you in touch with them. You won't be disappointed. Please join me in welcoming to the stage Old Sound.
Thank you.
There is no mention of the holiday in the lyrics. It's about making the most of a snowy day by spending it with a loved one by the fire. In the book, Songwriters on Songwriting, by Paul Zolo, Sammy Kahn, the lyricist, said, "Let It Snow was written on holidays, Hollywood, and Vine on the hottest day of the year." I said to Jules Stein, "Why don't we go down to the beach and cool off?" He said, "Why don't we stay here and write a winter song?" I went to the typewriter. Oh, the weather outside is frightful, but the fire is so delightful. And since we've got no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.
Thank you.
Most people associate Blue Christmas with Elvis Presley, but the song had been around a decade before the King recorded it. The heartbroken tale of unrequited love during the holidays had long been considered a Christmas staple of country music, having been recorded by Ernest Tubb in 1948. Elvis Presley effectively made Blue Christmas a steadfast rock and roll holiday classic by recording it in his signature style in 1957. The song has since been recorded by a host of rock and country artists, as well as those of other genres. The song was also featured in the children's Christmas special, The Year Without Santa Claus. There have been more than 65 significant recorded versions. It has won 4 awards for wonderful song lyrics, meaning, and tune. Program with the Good King Swings. It includes Deck the Hall, Ding Dong, Merrily on High, I Saw Three Ships, and We Wish You a Merry Christmas. Featured in this number will be our vocal soloist, Miss Bridget High. Bridget is a graduate of Temple Christian School, where she enjoyed the many blessings God has given her. Throughout school, she was involved in choir, band, volleyball, cheerleading, and musical productions. Bridget attends Lima Baptist Temple, where she is serving a youth group and has the privilege to be part of the praise and worship team. Bridget has enjoyed the Hallelujah Saints band from the time when she was little and would go to practices to listen. At 6 or 7 years old, she was thrilled when Wally asked her to play the sleigh bells. Since that time, she has joined the saxophone section and has been playing off and on when her school activities have allowed. Bridget is currently a teacher aide for Temple Christian School. She also enjoys playing piano, guitar, and her ukulele. Bridget says, "Always have a song in your heart," and her friends often find her singing to herself. Please join me in welcoming to the stage Miss Bridget High.
Thank you.
Louis Redner added the music. Here's our version of O Little Town of Bethlehem.
Thank you.
chance to make a donation for the concert tonight, we really appreciate that you take care of that during this, our 10-minute intermission. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
bugle calls and bugle call-like figures. As usual, in Anderson's music, both the solo parts and the rest of the orchestration are highly accomplished and meticulous. Bugler's Holiday became a favorite almost immediately and has remained a popular work ever since. Featuring the Holy Saints Band trumpet section, here's our version of Bugler's Holiday.
Thank you.
According to the Guinness Book of World Records, the version sung by Bing Crosby is the best-selling single of all time, with estimated sales in excess of 50 million copies worldwide. Accounts vary as to when and where Berlin wrote the song. One story is that he wrote it in 1940, poolside at the Biltmore Hotel in Phoenix, Arizona. He often stayed up all night writing. He told his secretary, "Grab your pen and take down this song. I just wrote the best song I've ever written. I just wrote the best song that anybody's ever written. Sit back and enjoy White Christmas."
Placide's handicap, he went on to win
to win awards as an artist and a journalist. In addition, he studied law and followed in his father's footsteps to become a merchant of wines and spirits. Bastide was an outspoken socialist with anti-clerical viewpoints. In 1847, while traveling by stagecoach to Paris, Bastide penned the words to a poem about the birth of Christ. He wrote the poem at the request of a local parish priest. He called it Minuit Caridien. Adolphe Charles Adam was also born in Paris. His father was a composer and professor at the Paris Conservatory. Early on, Adolphe proved to have a musical gift. He preferred to improvise rather than to study music. At the age of 18, at his father's insistence, Adolphe agreed to begin taking his music seriously. After graduation from the Paris Conservatory, Adolphe went on to write or co-write more than 50 ballets, operas, and musical scores. Adolphe was asked to write a musical score for Placide's poem. The music and poem together were called Cantate de Noël. In 1855, a Unitarian minister, John Sullivan Dwight, was America's first influential classical music critic. He translated the carol into English. On Christmas Eve, 1906, Reginald Fessenden, a Canadian inventor, broadcast the very first AM radio program, which included him playing a violin solo. The hymn he chose as the first musical piece to ever be broadcast via radio airways was O Holy Night. Here's our concert band version of O Holy Night, entitled A Noel Night.
Thank you.
toy shop door is locked up tight and everything is quiet for the night. When suddenly the clock strikes 12, the fun's begun. The dolls are in their best array. There's going to be a wonderful parade. Hark to the drum. Oh, here they come, cries everyone. Hear them all cheering? Now they're all nearing. There's the captain, stiff as starch. Bayonets flashing, music is crashing as the wooden soldiers march. Sabers a-clinking, soldiers a-winking at each pretty little maid. Here they come, here they come, here they come, here they come, wooden soldiers on parade.
Thank you. 2,000 years ago, God gave us the greatest gift there ever was, and that was His Son, Jesus Christ. In Ephesians, it talks about we are saved by grace through faith, and it is the gift of God. And what a gift you have. This Santa has Jesus in his heart. And I'm offering him to you this free gift tonight. Just simply confess with your mouth and believe in your heart that God has raised Jesus Christ from the dead, and thou shalt be saved. It's the greatest gift we will ever have, because it's all about eternal life through Jesus Christ. It's a free will choice. No one forces no one. God never forced anything, because it was all done on a free will. So with that, Merry Christmas to y'all. Remember, Jesus is the reason for the season, and why the men still see him.
Down to earth for us. This song is all about pressure. great song. I know I mentioned earlier about one of the songs being inspired, but that one has to be inspired, and that man was anointed by God when he wrote that. It's just wonderful. Our last number of the evening combines "We Wish You a Merry Christmas" and "Auld Lang Syne" in a delightful piece entitled "A Christmas Auld Lang Syne." In "Auld Lang Syne," the lyrics refer to a desire to remember old friendships, and its popularization as a New Year's song is often associated with Canadian band leader Guy Lombardo. The Christmas version goes like this. When mistletoe and tinsel glow, paint a yuletide valentine, back home I go to those I know for a Christmas auld lang syne. And as we gather round the tree, our voices all combine in sweet accord to thank our Lord for a Christmas auld lang syne. When sleigh bells ring and choirs sing and the children's faces shine, with each new toy we share their joy with a Christmas auld lang syne. We sing his praise this day of days and pray next year this time we'll all be near to share the cheer of a Christmas auld lang syne. In sweet accord to thank our Lord for a Christmas auld lang syne. We hope your Christmas season will be blessed by the gift of Jesus' presence, and that next year we'll all be here to share a Christmas auld lang syne.